Today I will explain how to palpate liver and spleen in a child. Now before you start interaction with the child, you must be ensuring that you introduce yourself to the child and to the parents and also take his introduction. Now you have to ensure that your hands are warm and clean. In an older child, you can examine the child in a supine position by standing on the right side of the patient and flexing his thighs and knees. But in a smaller child, like an infant, you have to examine the child in the lap of the mother. You can ask the mother to feed the child so that the abdomen relaxes, and that would make you easier to palpate the liver and spleen in an infant. Now, coming to the examination of the liver. Start from the right iliac fossa. You should keep your hands parallel to the rib margin, and you should palpate the liver from your radial border of your index finger. Starting from here, with each breath, you have to press your hands gently and feel for the enlargement. Remember to keep your hands flat on the surface of the abdomen, and remember not to poke the abdomen too hard. With each breath, you have to move upwards. There is one another method in which you can use the fingertips to palpate the margins of the liver. Here again, you have to start from the lower margin of the right iliac fossa and gradually move upwards towards the costal margin, right costal margin, to feel for the borders of the liver. Remember to keep your hands flat on the surface of the abdomen, and it will be a good idea if your hands and forearm are in the same straight line while examining for the liver. Whenever you feel that yes, liver is palpable, then you have to be checking the size of the liver as well as surface of the liver, consistency, margins, and whether it is tender or not. Now coming to the examination of the spleen. Now for examination of the spleen, you have to start from the right iliac fossa and move towards the left costal margin. You have to support the rib cage by keeping your left hand on the border. Ask the child to be in the same position. Beta, aise hi rakhna pair hai na, aaram se. Koi dikkat hoga to batana, theek hai? Start from the right iliac fossa, and you will examine the spleen from the tips of the finger. So your tips should be pointing towards the costal margin. Keep your hands flat, and with each breath, move towards the left costal margin in this diagonal fashion. Now, with each inspiration, we feel for whether the tip of the spleen is coming and touching the fingertip or not. Once you have reached the costal margin, be sure to palpate all along the border of the costal margin for any splenic enlargement. And once you have palpated that yes, spleen is you are able to palpate the spleen, then you need to be sure that that is spleen and not kidney. You can do that by checking for the splenic notch, if it is present or not. Your fingers should not dip. If there's in a splenomegaly, your fingers should not dip inside between the organ and the rib cage. And apart from that, it should not be bi-manually palatable. And also there shouldn't, the band of resonance should be absent in a splenomegaly while it is present in a left kidney enlargement. Now there is another method for examining spleen, which is very small or just palpable. For that, you need to change the position of the child to the right lateral position. Beta, idhar karvat le lo to, is side karvat le lo, halka sa, halka sa, aaram se, very good, yes, bahut aaram se, koi dikkat nahi hai, theek, very good, aaram se, dheere dheere dheere, theek, aaram se haath rakho. Again, here also we palpate from the tips of the fingers, and starting from the right iliac fossa and supporting the rib cage with the left hand, we move upwards towards the left costal margin. And with each inspiration, we try to feel for any splenic enlargement. Beta, lamba lamba saas lo mukh khol ke. Very good. It's a good idea to ask the child to inspire. Because with each inspiration, with inspire deeply, because with each inspiration, you can feel whether the spleen is coming down and touching your fingers or not. So, once I have come here, I am moving all along the costal margin to feel for the splenic enlargement. And I am taking care that I am not poking him too hard.